I really try to be a good teammate. You know, all the things I always preach on this channel, like joining voice comms, being positive, swapping when necessary, and all that other crap. But as it turns out, being a dick is just that much easier, and not only is it easier, I also win more games. So the following move seems obvious, right? Get into your next ranked match and don't be shy to point out every single misplay your teammates are doing together with a "you better uninstall this game, fucking boosted ass trash player." Okay, maybe that's not exactly what I'm talking about. Hey, what's up guys, Boosted Platinum here, and today we're going to discuss whether or not being a dick might actually win you more games. Now I want to differentiate between what kind of dick I'm talking about. I mean, what kind of asshole? Is there a reason we use body parts as insults? So what I'm talking about today is not the troll type of player who intentionally loses games. I don't mean the bastion smurfs who throw themselves off the map, or the types of douchebags who just insult everyone on voice. Let alone the 12-year-olds who are too scared to join voice chat and thus only talk shit in text chat. What I mean specifically are the types of players who actively refuse to do things that are universally considered the right thing. Or, you know, the other way around, willingly do things that are considered the wrong thing. Often labeled selfish and the like. It's almost like I'm summarizing what I've been talking about the past couple weeks on this channel, why people refuse to join voice chat and why people decide to only play a single hero, for example. The first question that we should ask ourselves in this discussion is, why would people actively practice these things? Why would they want to do things that are universally considered wrong? The answer is often very simple. Because it works. It's easy for you to say that the Genji main you just played with is a trash player. It's also easy to say things like, swap off Torbjorn, don't you want to win? But if we approach this logically, most players have the same goal, which is winning, and again, we're excluding people who troll and throw on purpose. So if you look at that Genji or Torbjorn and you're about to ask why they don't swap, the answer is probably because they feel like they have the better chance of winning if they don't. And that is actually quite natural. Obviously, players feel like they're doing the most work on characters that they're strong with, and the fact that the enemies try to counter them might just motivate them to put even more effort rather than immediately swapping. Some of you might bring up the meme set that is win percent, but fact of the matter is that a shit ton of things can affect your win rate even without you being able to do anything about it. What if they had people throw because they didn't like them not swapping off or tilted unjustifyingly? What if in the past they did swap midway through and still ended up losing? They might have this nagging feeling of, if only I didn't swap, maybe I could have been able to do more. And as a result, even if not swapping loses them the game, they feel like they tried everything in their power to win. Even if their pick was not optimal, it was still their strongest character. And I feel like at this point I should just reuse the disclaimer I put into my one trick video, because a lot of people like to get very upset over me saying things like this. And to ease us into the discussion, I'd like to dismiss the notion that keeping quiet about something is the better alternative to analyzing and talking about it. At the end of the day, talking about an issue does not forcefully convince people to practice said problem. I've seen that under my own, as also other YouTubers' videos. Delete this video, you're just giving people an excuse to do thing XYZ. Those comments are exactly why talking about it is so important, because those statements are either based on ignorance or quite simply a lack of information and perspective. And it's not like your strategy of not talking about it makes it so people stop doing it. One trick's been around forever, even with nobody highlighting the issue. So at the end of the day, it usually comes down to people perceiving their course of action to make sense, and same goes for the whole voice chat discussion. As much as we preach that communication can be a huge advantage, sometimes it does the opposite. It can be distracting or even just straight up annoying, and that can result in you playing worse. You know, people like to be real smartasses, proposing the obvious as though the person in question did not consider that. Hey, if your proposed solution works for you, that's cool, more power to you, but not everyone is the same. Taking myself as an example, I usually stay in voice chat until my team has proven to me that it's pointless. I listen to their bullshit until I figure, okay, there's actually no valuable information coming whatsoever and everyone's just whining, I'm out. But others might have less tolerance for crap like that, and that is absolutely fair. People have pointed out that muting single players is an option in this game as if it is the ultimate solution. And again, it might be for you, and that's cool, but a lot of people think differently. If they figure that the vast majority of their experiences in voice chat has been negative, then there's no reason for them to give it a chance. And even I, while knowing I could easily do that, sometimes just don't feel like engaging with this kind of bullshit to begin with. So we just cancel voice chat as an option for the entirety of our session. It helps us focus on nothing but our gameplay. What I want to make you understand in this discussion is that players do these kinds of things not because they have a desire to lose. In fact, it is the exact opposite. We are all bound to make different experiences when playing. Where one player might find a lot of value in communication, others just get annoyed. So both players do what seems reasonable to to them in their individual cases. Which for the first one would be muting individual troublemakers, but for the other one might just be refusing to join voice chat to stay focused on their game rather than getting annoyed. And when it comes to refusing to swap heroes, there's more to it than just the merit that's their strongest pick even when countered. Because as a matter of fact, there are a lot of benefits to one-tricking if done properly. I've actually gone as far as to suggesting my friends to one-trick a hero if they feel like they're stuck in their elo since multiple seasons, and there is good reason for doing that. If you focus all of your attention on learning a single hero, you'll learn how to make a bigger impact on them. Sure, in your learning phase you might lose a bunch because you're being countered or don't know how to handle certain engagements, but in the long run you'll learn a lot of valuable lessons like how to counter your counters for example, or just how to play around them. There are a lot of nuances that you can't really grab a hold of if you always swap off your hero at the sight of trouble. Needless to say that you also get better at a much faster rate if you only play a single character rather than the entire cast. How often did I refer to Overwatch as a gamble? Well, in videos only a couple times, but still. Overwatch very often feels like a gamble for flex players, and I've been in the same boat. I did not climb out of Platinum until I started maining Zenyatta and Ana, and it was also me playing Ana almost non-stop that got me into Masters in the first place. Now I did the same thing. Sure, I got into 3.4k playing flex before, but then RNGesus decided to smite my SR and give me a lot of teammates that I, at that time, would have labeled as incompetent. Because again, that's just what it feels like as a flex player. It's the notion of, I let all of you choose your heroes first, filled the comp, and you still did not manage to do your job? That's just terribly frustrating. And now, with me deciding to only play Zenyatta, even when I play worse on stream than I do off stream because of the additional distraction, I still feel like I'm going somewhere. I feel like I'm getting better over time and pull my weight much more effectively, and my SR does reflect that after the learning phase. For a lot of one tricks, their losses feel less frustrating because they played their best character at the best of their capabilities. If that is not enough, then that's just that. Simultaneously, their wins feel much more satisfying and they actually feel like they're improving at a much more constant rate. So as much as the devs try to promote swapping heroes as a key feature, the best way to rank up just seems to be deciding to play a single hero or just a few at best. You get better at a much faster rate, your MMR can be calculated much more easily, which also means that you find your actual place on the ladder faster, and there is also a stronger sense of perceived improvement than making your wins dependent on swapping and hoping. Which brings us back to the question that we asked in the very beginning. Why would people do things that are universally considered wrong? Well, counter question, why do we see so many one tricks and masters and GM? The answer stays the same, because it works. And that's usually what people operate under when they do things like that. They do it because from their point of view, with their experience, it just makes the most sense. People will practice whatever benefits their goal the most, and usually their goal is winning the majority of their matches. So even if you think whatever they're doing is throwing the game, chances are that they had great success doing that in at least 51% of their matches. And if nothing else, maybe it's just something they decided to do for their own enjoyment, doing whatever it takes to enjoy their time in a video game for as long as possible without getting annoyed. If leaving voice chat means they can't get yelled at anymore for playing characters they enjoy playing and feel useful with, then that's exactly what they're going to do. So the question that we should really ask ourselves is not why they're doing it, but rather why it works and how we can use that knowledge to our advantage. Again, every last bit is dependent on your individual scenario. It depends on how useful you perceive voice chat to be, and it depends on how useful you perceive your own performance on certain heroes to be. Sometimes doing the wrong thing might just be the right thing for you. If you enjoy playing this game more without voice chat, then don't use it. If you feel more useful in a hero that you deem good, then go ahead and play them. Learn from your mistakes along the way and strive for improvement based on that. At the end of the day, it is not a question of whether or not you want to be an asshole, but more about how much assholery is the right amount for you. Is muting individual people good enough for you, or do you want to leave voice chat entirely? Do you want to insist on playing a single hero, or do you still want to swap when you feel the time is right? Those are the kinds of decisions that only you can make. Some players win more games by constantly swapping, and others perform better if they just play a single hero. Ultimately, the only thing that really matters is that whatever you do, you give your best while doing it. Your one trick journey might not start in Grandmaster, but don't let people tell you that playing whatever you personally feel is fun and useful is the wrong thing. You might not always be right, but those are the kinds of mistakes that you have to make to learn from them and never do them again. Having someone else yell at you is not gonna achieve that. And just as a closing thought from yours truly, when it comes to my personal opinion, I do not think that the problem lies with people doing these things that are considered wrong. I don't feel like players who refuse to join voice chat or refuse to swap heroes are the issue here. More so, I feel the problem is the community that decide to approach these issues in such a hostile manner that others experience more success as practicing these wrong things than playing the game in the right way. And ultimately, it's not always about playing video games in the most optimal way possible. Sometimes it's more about, you know, having fun. But this is me done for the day as I talk about Overwatch and how being a bit of a dick might sometimes be the right thing to do. Boy, do I look forward to reading the comments under this one. So as always, if you enjoyed the video, do let me know by dropping me a like on your way out. Subscribe if you want to see more, and hope to see y'all next time. Ray has been getting play the game every single game again. God damn it.
Is that
six double?
Six double kill.
Holy shit. Nice.